another episode of Wake Up with the Wiltshires.
Yes, and happy Cinco de Mayo, the 5th of May. We're back to you. We took a few days off to get some ideas flowing into our head and enjoy some of that beautiful weather that's out there as well. And we had already done a Star Wars episode earlier, so May the 4th be with you, but we had run out of Star Wars themes as well, so hope you had a good time yesterday. We watched yesterday, though, just to wrap up Star Wars, May the 4th, before we move on to Cinco de Mayo, we started watching Rise of Skywalker yesterday. It came out on Disney Plus on May the 4th, which was great. And Stephen, what do you think about Rise of Skywalker?
I liked it a lot.
Favorite movie out of the 9 episodes? Yeah. Ooh, okay, that's all right. You heard it there. It says favorite one out of the 9 episodes. I'm still pretty fond of Return of the Jedi, Empire Strikes Back from when I was a kid.
Revenge of the Sith.
But what about you, Caitlin?
I've only watched the beginning of it, so I have to watch.
Gotta wait and see. She's holding her thoughts until she
knows. I think the one before that, I like.
The
Last Jedi.
The Last Jedi?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good one, too.
Because, I like the movies with Rey in it because she's my favorite character.
Yeah. Definitely like the movies with Rey over there for sure. It is Cinco de Mayo, and Cinco de Mayo, we did a little research. Cinco de Mayo celebrates, it's not a huge holiday in Mexico, believe it or not. It's just one state in Mexico that celebrates this. And it celebrates something called the Battle of Puebla, which took place in 1861 against the French. Really small celebration, but it's transformed into America to be more of a celebration of Mexican heritage and culture. It happens to fall on Tuesday, which is great because it's
Taco Tuesday.
It's Taco Tuesday, yes. Cinco de Mayo on Taco Tuesday. What better could you ask for? And of course, you know, here we are finding ourselves in the Corona virus time. So it's pretty ironic, I would say so myself. So that is, Stephen, what is the number of the day and our word of the day?
Number of the day is 5, and the word of the day is Cinco.
Yep, number of the day is 5, word of the day is Cinco.
And Cinco means 5 in Spanish.
Cinco is 5 in Spanish, that's right. So maybe learn how to count in Spanish today. That would be a good thing to do. And, you know, definitely think about the number 5 as well. It is a prime number, as we've been talking about a lot. Prime numbers, composite numbers, odd, even, lots of different things you can do. All right, we have a few birthdays to catch up on. We missed a few. Hope you celebrated your birthdays over the weekend and yesterday. But here we are. Andrew, Spencer, Matthew, Henry, Colm, Emerson, Anthony, Diamond, Caden, Lila, David, Maisie, and Isabella. Happy birthday to all of you. We hope you enjoyed your special day this weekend, or if it was yesterday, you know, as we kind of catch up on a few birthdays that we have over the last few days. I also want to thank my kids and Mrs. Wiltshire for a great Principal's Day and all the emails that I got from some parents and kids out there. Thank you so much. It made me really feel special and very glad to get those. And as we move now to Teacher Appreciation Week, very important week. Our teachers are working tremendously hard. Stephen, any teachers you want to thank? We're going to be thanking teachers that we know every day. But today, any teachers come to mind you'd like to thank?
I like to thank my teachers, Mrs. Hahn and Mr. Yaskis.
All right.
For being just awesome.
Awesome teachers. You heard it there. Mrs. Hahn, Mr. Yaskis, thank you for being awesome teachers. Thanks for everything you're doing right now, too, to keep this kid learning here. And Kaylin, how about you? Any teachers you'd like to thank?
I actually have 3. Mrs. Burnell, Mrs. Wackachore, and Mrs. Mayo.
All right, some teachers you've had, right? Yeah, those are the teachers you've had at Elmwood Street School. And yes, big thank you to all of them. I'd like to thank, to start the week for me, I would like to thank our North Street teachers. You guys have been absolutely amazing. You know, it's been so impressive that what you've done in such a short amount of time and your outreach to the kids, you care so much about them. Hey kids, don't tell the teachers, but you know, you can send them a little message and thank them. It doesn't have to be anything special, just a little couple words. I tell you, those messages, kids, mean a lot to teachers, more so than material items that you might get if we were in school, flowers and things. Just send them a little email. Let them know how much you appreciate what they're doing and how much you care about them. Please do that. They will like it. Trust me. All right. Now, moving on to our word challenge here. The top one there was from last week. We finished the week. That is look around you. Look around you. And now the next one there, we have intersecting roads there, but it's not intersecting roads. So think about that. Okay. Think about that. We'll let you know what the winner is, what the word is tomorrow. But speaking of winners, we have finally wrapped up the March Madness, April Madness, now May Madness Animal Adaptations Challenge. We had the Mimic Octopus versus the Pufferfish, and by a large amount, the Mimic Octopus destroys with 83% of the votes. They went on to win. I mean, this thing is really cool. KK, do you remember the Mimic Octopus? Pretty cool adaptations, right?
Yeah.
What does that word mimic mean? Do you remember?
Copy.
Copy something?
Like mimic something.
Yeah.
Like copying another animal and kind of blend into it. It pretends it's other animals or plants or something and imitates in its environment.
So it makes itself look like other things. I mean, and there was like dozens of things it can make itself look like. I mean, it's a master magician. And if you haven't yet, check it out. But Mimic Octopus, we've decided, North Street School, that the Mimic Octopus is the best adaptation to survive in its habitat out of all the animals that we studied. So, well done, well done. Let's keep that learning going. And there's lots of other animals you can learn about there as well. All right, well, you know, I do have some jokes, but I really like Star Wars jokes. So we're going to go back to May the 4th for just a moment for funny jokes with
Dad.
And my first joke here, I heard yesterday actually from Mrs. Wiltshire, how do Wookiees like to make their cookies?
Oh, she told us all of that, I know.
How do they make to make their cookies?
Chewy!
Chewy, of course, Chewy. And if you didn't know, a Wookiee is Chewbacca. Chewbacca is a Wookiee. That's where that joke comes from. And what kind of car does a Jedi drive?
Oh,
well, of course, they drive a Toyota. Yoda, Toyota.
I have a joke.
You have a joke, alright.
What's a Jedi's favorite candy?
What's a Jedi's favorite candy?
Lifesavers.
Ah, Lifesavers. I get it. Any jokes from you, Caitlin?
Nope, okay.
Not today. Alright, yep. And speaking of Fiesta, let's wrap up with our wacky words with the Wiltshire. Fiesta happens to be my word, and Fiesta is Spanish for party. And you know, today there are different parties and celebrations around this holiday in the Mexican culture. KK, what do you have for us?
I have
siesta.
Siesta.
Yeah, so you were napping there, weren't you?
Yes. It means sleep time.
Oh, right. It means sleep time, yeah. Yeah, nap time, siesta. Might need a siesta later before I fiesta. Oh, you might need a siesta after you fiesta. Right? All right, and Stephen, what do you have?
I have Mariachi.
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 Yeah, you got
it's a Mexican band.
Yes, a mariachi band. Do you have any music that's a mariachi band you can play for us, Stephen?
Maybe the
beginning of that song there. Yeah, yeah.
You get it?
We're getting it for you. There you go. There you go, mariachi band. Say it, KK. Mariachi.
Mariachi.
Yeah, mariachi.
Very fun to say. All right, there you go. Fiesta, siesta, and mariachi are the words, wacky words with the Wiltshires. And finally, just want to wrap up with new learning going on this week, kids. So make sure you're signing into your Schoology sixth graders, your Google Classroom, and make sure you're checking out those teachers' comments. So there's new content going out there, parents and kids, so that you can learn some new things as we get, you know, look ahead to the rest of this school year. So I know you guys are doing the same. And that seems to be what most are doing right now. So keep that at-home learning going. You guys are doing an awesome job. I'm so proud of you. Keep it up. And as a reminder, it's always a great day to
smile.
Come on your head. I'm your more. You make